That's what I respect. I'm gone.
Pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel matchup with the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And this one is underway here on EA Sports. Wishing he had a mulligan. That's not how you want to start the game.
Not at all, because not only do you give up the penalty and good field position, but it just kills the momentum of your team as you start a game.
Play fake. Here's Wilson. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Behind the chain, second and 12. Play action, it's Wilson. Rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
It's complete to Fuller, and he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain. Got a man complete, it's Fuller again. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. And he stopped immediately there.
It was Quiddy Pay who made the stop coming off the edge.
And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 49.
Not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward, since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school is he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And this is caught, and he almost made it, but just short, finally out of bounds, right down around the goal line. It's a big play there for Atlanta.
First and goal at the one.
They go play action with Wilson. They'll roll him out right. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Juwan Johnson there to make the grab. And the Falcons have taken the early lead.
Extra point by Nagar is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Kaepernick now to throw. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ashton Davis. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
Not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now two interceptions thrown.
Well, the good ones, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the two interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to zone blitz.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Jerry Jeudy, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Falcons lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Extra point by Nagar is up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? And maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire.
And he'll be tackled at about the 35.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it.
And this is going to be an Eagles first down as good running gets him to about the 44. And you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Now they'll throw with Kaepernick. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. After the loss, they'll come up 2nd and 13. To throw, Kaepernick. Flushed out right. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 26.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, 2nd down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
That's going to be caught. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
That's the 3rd time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going, and right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Edwards-Helaire, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Again, Edwards-Helaire, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing 3, and now it's 3rd down. Extra point by Butker is on target, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. 14, 7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Thomas. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Offense out there for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
They go play action now. Wilson on the move to his left. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. He's got a man complete.
Pass him in this.
Touchdown, Falcons.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
Extra point by Nagar is up and good. And it's now 21-7. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Offense set to begin their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do. If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And that's going to lead to a third down. Out to punt here on fourth down. Back deep, Antonio Brown. Broken tackle. It'll go as a 42, make it a 43-yard punt. Six on the return. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is, they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Here's Wilson to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. On second down, it's Pollard. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Trying to run for it with Pollard.
And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down. It's Wilson on the option. And not only did he not get in the end zone, he didn't get the first down either. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Able to complete this one to Tyler Conklin. And he will finally go out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big play there just before halftime. So forget about being backed up. Here's a first and 10 all the way across midfield. To throw, it's Kaepernick. Eluding the pressure right. Going deep for Diggs. And this one is incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick. Looking again for Diggs, and this time he's got it. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. It's Kaepernick. Open man here is Conklin. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Now Kaepernick. Buying time to his left. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. This is a quick incompletion. This is likely the last play here of this first half. A final shot before half for Kaepernick. Touchdown! Odell Beckham in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
It's a new season, so both of these coaching staffs likely making plenty of adjustments after their first half of football. So for the call of the second half here in week one, we go back to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point.
And we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. Uses the stiff arm. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
43 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
Here's Edwards-Helaire. Darius Williams in there to make the tackle.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Working with second and five now.
Now a play fake. Kaepernick. That's caught by Hollister. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out.
We got this.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and sent him on a crossing route. And this works really well where you can find that space between levels. And they were able to do so for good yardage.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Ashton Davis.
Through an opening, and there he goes.
Right down there.
Oh. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown.
Nagar now for the point after.
He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now Kaepernick. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 38. And this one will be brought back to the 22. So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
Wilson going to try once more.
And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19. On second down, Pollard. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Man open left side is Brown. Touchdown, Falcons!
You have fun with this one, partner.
He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. It's Kaepernick. Open man is Pettis. It's complete. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They fake the give. Now Kaepernick. Looking left side and it's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Here's Kaepernick to throw. Steps away to his left. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. The Eagles on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and four. To throw, Kaepernick. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by the linebacker, Jordan Hicks. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a terrific return as he brings this one all the way back to the 30.
You and I have been around teams, and they all have goals for games, don't they? And every team we've ever talked to says what?
No turnover.
Don't turn the ball over. Zero. And they were that close to getting it done. Won't cost them today, but they'll hate that when they're watching the game tape.
And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire.
And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. The Eagles on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and 8. On play action, it's Kaepernick. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will not get what he needed as he stops short of the first down at around the 22. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. Now Kaepernick, gotta have this one. Looking to complete it to Pettis, and he's got him. And he gets this down to the 18, good enough for a first down. Here's Kaepernick. He's got a man, that's Marshall.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. To throw is Kaepernick. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Terrace Marshall
with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Eagles have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead will be cut down to 14. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They've got the 2-score lead. It looked low. They fumbled last possession, led to a touchdown. So while things look good here at this stage in the 4th, they got to be careful.
They definitely do, because they've actually brought them back into it, haven't they? They've given them hope once again. Their purpose on this drive, squash that hope one more time.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Out of the gun, here's Wilson.
Swinging this out for Pollard.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Now a whistle and a timeout defensively. Trying to stop it, and they do with 2 seconds to go prior to the 2-minute warning. Here's 2nd and 9. Gonna run again here with Pollard. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Steps away. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Second time he's fumbled in this game. Fortunate for him, this one goes out of bounds.
And the key for him now is how much equity have you built up with your coaching staff? How much equity have you built up with your team to continue to get opportunities? Fortunate that one went out of bounds, saved him from a turnover.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll run for it with Pollard. Oh, and I think he went backward. He did. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Kaepernick now on first down. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3. A big play there for Philly.
Well, he reminded us that he was a 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one picking up right where he left off. He told us at the end of the preseason he was primed for a big year. He just gave us excellent evidence of his belief.
Kaepernick now to throw. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
They do tack on the extra point as well. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. And they just about had to get that recovery to have any chance. They only have one timeout. You look at the clock. Now let's do the math here, Charles. This one's pretty much over.
Yeah, we do have a chart here, don't we, that tells us about the timeouts.
You do. I'm not as smart as you.
And in looking at it, you're exactly right. Chart's not going to help them here at all. They're pretty much done at this stage. They had to have that recovery.
Elsewhere, Ford Field, they're into the fourth quarter now. And the Lions have now taken the lead in that ball game. A win would be their second on the young season. Wilson wants to throw it. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds.
Now, that's a big pickup right there. And so often, we focus on how the quarterback's faking out play action. How about everyone being in on the deal and picking it up?
Second, third levels, you can see them trying to recover. They bit. Worked out offensively. They'll run on first down. Pollard. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
40 yards on the ground for him so far.
I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. Second down at 7. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Oh, Wilson going to throw. Flush to his right. And that is caught. Touchdown. Well, there is a marker on the field. The celebration may be short-lived. Let's see. The penalty yards marched off as they'll try again on second and goal. Throwing now is Wilson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Eagles are right back in this football game. So, my goodness, I wouldn't have thought this possible not too long ago, but that turnover there means we have a game again.
Yeah, it's been a completely different team here in the second half. I just wonder on the other side of the field, where the starters telling the backups, get ready, you're going to get some playing time. And now guess what? Hope they didn't cut the tape off of their wrists and ankles. They've got to go back out there and play.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They have time here, partner, for just one final heave.
And I have to look at it from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down there and throw it in the end zone, tip it around and catch it. You've got to have guys back there to defend that, but also you can't allow the quarterback as much time as he wants to set up and throw it. Maybe you bring a little extra pressure to make sure he gets rid of it quicker.
A little bit of a cat-and-mouse game. We'll see if they bring that pressure. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for the Falcons, it was a hard-fought game, and they'll exit 1-0 as they win by a touchdown. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against San Francisco.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone, I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding in that four-door Audi, when it smoke, they get to hide and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it, I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's, I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup, tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full, won't fold on me. How you claim me?
one. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Like verse.